welcome to Church of the Valley. And this is our last online service before we return to in-person worship next week. Let us begin in prayer. Holy God, we thank you for this day. We thank you for this important week that is before us. And we thank you for your Son who taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
So today's first epistle reading is Galatians 2:20. And it is no longer I who live, but it is Christ who lives in me. And the life I now live in the flesh, I live by faith in the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me. Amen.
Time of prayer. As I have been doing each week, I will begin the prayer, but I will leave a space in the middle so that at home you can speak out your prayers, concerns, and joys, or post them down below. Now, let us go to prayer. Holy God, we want to thank you for getting us through the past 14 months. We are almost to the end of our time apart, and it is bringing such joy to our hearts. We thank you for the contributions that those people have made for our worship videos online. Wesley, thank you so much for being our photographer. Band, thank you so much for providing worshipful music. All of those people who have shared stewardship moments, all of our singers. But now it is time for us to come back together. And Lord, we ask that you have us do it in a way that is safe, keeps us all healthy, and is a way that can make this church even stronger. Today we also lift up these concerns. And it is in your Holy Son's name we pray. Amen.
Hi, I'm Rick Hall. I usually attend the 10:30 service, and I'm the chairman of the property committee. So that means I fix all the things you break. But you know what? I haven't had anything to fix lately because we haven't been here. You know, when this whole pandemic started, Laura and I were very practical people, and we thought, how's the church going to make it financially? Well, you kept giving. We all did. We were all part of something bigger. And when you give, when you're here, you see something. You know, you have the community, you're part of something, but it's really hard to be part of that community when you can't get together, and yet you did, and you have. And when you do something like that, not knowing the outcome, it's called faith. And I appreciate your faith throughout the last 14 months. So keep giving to the church. There are three ways you can give. You can send a check to the church office here at COB. You can drop a check in the offering box at LBC, or you can give online with PayPal.
I hope you've had time to gather your elements for communion. Now, let us go to the table. When they were gathered in one place, after giving thanks, he took the bread and broke it and said, "This is my body. Take, eat, each of you." Let's take the bread together. Then he took the cup and said, "This is the blood of the new covenant poured out for forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me." Let's take the cup together. And now let us pray. Loving God, we thank you for our time at this table of love, this table of new life. It's in your Son's name we pray. Amen. The scripture reading today is John 15, verses 4 and 5. "Abide in me as I abide in you. Just as the branch cannot bear fruit by itself unless it abides in the vine, neither can you unless you abide in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. Those who abide in me and I in them bear much fruit, because apart from me, you can do nothing." Amen. 2 weeks ago, I was here at Church of the Valley to shoot our worship video, and one of the other people who was participating in the video said to me, "You know, when I drove in today, I saw your car sitting in the parking lot, and I thought to myself, that really is the Kosick Mobile." He said, "You know, you've had that car so long, I can't picture you driving another car." Apparently, in his mind, part of who I am is associated with my car. There are many things in this world that we associate with other things. Peanut butter and jelly, salt and pepper, shoes and socks. And then there are even things that we associate with something else that are almost useless without the other. Golf clubs are useless without golf balls. To use a can opener, you need a can. A door needs hinges. To use a Phillips head screw, you need a Phillips head screwdriver. A dartboard needs darts. A pen needs paper to write on. Paint needs a paintbrush. Knitting needles need yarn. A tire is useless without air. You can't use staples without a stapler. Your printer needs toner. Your sailboat needs sails. And a remote control needs a television. Which raises the question, why do I have so many remote controls for one television? So, it's pretty common for one thing to rely on another. And for something to be so associated with something else, we can't imagine it standing alone. In today's scripture, Christ invites us to abide in him. To abide means to act in accordance with. We are invited to act in harmony with Christ, who already acts in harmony with us. He says, "I am the vine, you are the branches." The branch cannot bear fruit by itself. They rely on one another. One does not exist without the other. Christ is calling on us to create a relationship with him where one does not exist without the other. And furthermore saying, apart from me, you can do nothing. You know, we talk a lot about following Christ. And when we think about following Christ, we think about him being our shepherd, guiding us, teaching us. When we think about following Christ, we think about obeying him, living by his message, following the word. But I think his invitation to abide in him takes it a step farther. When we abide in Christ, we still follow him, but there is more. To abide in Christ, we make Christ a part of the essence of who we are. To abide in Christ is to make him such an important part of our makeup that we are unrecognizable without him. When we abide in Christ, all we do is done through him. Now, a further aspect of our abiding in Christ is that when we are acting in harmony with Christ, it is apparent to all of those around us. We've all known Christians like this, the saints among us, those Christians who are clearly walking in the light of Christ. I spent 35 years of my life with someone like that. When we find someone who is abiding in Christ and fully aware that Christ abides in them, we see Christ in all that they do. We see Christ in their decision making, in the way they speak to others, in acts of kindness. We see Christ in all of their heart, in all of their soul, and in all of their mind. When we come in contact with people like this, we believe that Christ is so much a part of them that we literally cannot separate the two. They abide in one another. This is what we must strive to achieve. A closeness to Christ that defines us. A closeness to Christ that defines us to others. A harmony with Christ that shows the world that without Christ, we can do nothing. Now, don't get me wrong. I don't mean to suggest that our relationship with Christ should be achieved to impress others or to prove to the world how in harmony we are with Jesus. No, it is a much more personal relationship. It's just that when we are in perfect harmony, abiding in Christ, our relationship with him, our closeness to him, cannot help but define us to others. There was a young woman on television not too long ago, and she was telling a story about how she had been kidnapped. And she had been taken by a man, and she was held against her will, and she had been abused. For days and days, she was locked in a room with very little food, and her hands and her feet were painfully bound. The young woman talked about trying to keep hope. She was a woman of faith. She was a Christian woman. And the way that she said that she held on to her hope was through talking to Christ. She said that she spent most of her time talking to Christ and asking him to help her, which is something that I believe that most of us would do if we were in a similar situation. But then she said something that not only surprised me, it also saddened me. She said that the reason that she kept an ongoing conversation with Christ was because she felt like if she wasn't talking to him, he wasn't there. This young woman felt that somehow Christ would leave her if she wasn't physically speaking to him. This was very sad to me. We must never feel this way. We must always understand that Christ abides within us, that Christ lives in harmony within us, He is our vine. We must remember to be his branches. Being his branches means that we depend on him for our survival. We rely on him for our strength. Being his branches means that he provides us with our life, which is the fruit of our existence. Go out this week and walk in the light of Christ. Accept his invitation to abide within him and allow yourself to bear the fruit, knowing that without him, we can do nothing. Let us pray. Holy God, we thank you for your Son. Help us to abide within him as we know he abides within us. And it's in his name we pray. Amen. If not, we will be streaming live this 10:30 service on Facebook Live. Stay safe, stay healthy. I love you all. We'll see you next week.